back to Best Spuds. We're still playing Monster Prom. Woo!
Hello!
Yeah, we had to do this again because...
Because Tone's bad at video games.
Tone's an idiot.
It's Monster Prom March.
It's Monster... And it's Monster Prom March. Woo!
Okay.
Nick, play the intro again. Dewan. Not Bic. Bibku. Named almost after my favorite sports player ever, Dewan Bibkus.
If that was basically to the whole thing.
I could, but it'll look stupid.
Yeah, that's the big problem.
I like Dewan Bibku. You're a professional skeetball. Don't you have his rookie card?
Yeah. I don't care.
I have his jersey, too.
Does it say Dewan or Bibkus on it?
It just says Dewan Bibkus.
Oh, awesome.
No, it's the name part says Dewan, and then instead of a number, it says Bibkus.
I like that. Is there an emoji on it ever?
Only under blacklight.
Only the away jersey has a emoji on it? Great. Laura
Nicolas.
Nicholas.
Got it. Love
Let's
it.
Try this again. Once more with the.
Yay, Tone. Okay. You can do it.
Red. Okay.
All right. You did it.
I'm really proud of you. You're making some strides, kid.
Yeah, this is what we call progress and character development here on Best Spuds.
No.
You didn't get this the last playthrough, did you?
No.
How many letters can you do?
I don't know. Give it a good count, Dan. I'm gonna say 10.
I guess I'm about to find out.
Damn it. I need a... Oh, okay, good. We're good. I got one, and it's not gonna be 8.
Snuggle?
I was a big fan of 8. Snuggles would be cool.
Snugglach. Snugglewoo.
Snugglewoo.
Snugglewumpus.
Snugglewumpus.
I'm so proud of you because that has nothing to do with a penis or a vagina.
I like it.
And that's all you talk about.
I'm
so
pretty
good for
sure.
Snugglewumps.
Consult Urban Dictionary, you'll be wrong.
And Daniel?
Yes, I will push the correct buttons. How do you...
He almost fucked it up. Ah, Vicky. Perfect.
Yes, of course.
Let us begin. Shart.
Yes, it's shark.
Charlemagne.
West.
Charlemagne.
Sick rap name.
Charlemagne.
Oh God, I'm with it. So mad.
In all caps.
Okay.
And we deck to experience the ultimate challenge, the Monster Prom. And then we already met all of these people, so who cares?
Oh, this is new to me.
Daniel's new to Laura, you ass.
I forgot.
It's new background art.
It is.
Yes, it's super cute.
Whatever, Monster Prom.
I was gonna say you and anyone else who missed it can just go watch our other episodes.
Dick.
There's a plan.
All right, let's do our quiz.
Okay, quiz time. Ooh, hunky cop. How'd you talk a cop out of arresting you? Use your gaming skills. Everyone knows that a police officer has to drop any charges on you if you manage to beat them at a fair Yu-Gi-Oh card duel. I'm not even reading the rest of them. I'm picking that one.
Nice.
Fair.
All right, use your seduction skills. Wink. They don't call it fuck the police for nothing. Or use your acting skills. Convince the officers you're actually the police. You know what? Go really overkill and make them pay you a fine.
I'm the police officer.
Yes, Laura, you have been. I'm so... Yes.
I am the police officer.
Go with that one.
So disappointed.
Yu-Gi-Oh, please.
All right. Daniel?
Well, you see, Charlemagne and I have differences of opinions. Charlemagne is an actor.
She's the police officer?
She is the police officer.
All right.
Great. You get the chance to produce a movie. It is based on the most influential Russian novelist of the, I don't know, Roman numerals. 19th century. I've gone nuts. They don't remember anything about last night, and now they can't find the manuscript of the Brothers Karamazov, and Dostoevsky has to deliver it today.
Oh, shit.
Two cool guys walking away from rad explosions, and they don't look at the explosions. They don't give a fuck about the explosions. They reflect on life and love, but it is super dope and kick-ass because they do so walking away from never-ending explosions. Or something about superheroes, but with a love triangle between a beautiful yet somewhat relatable girl. Maybe she's always stating she's a mess. And two of the super hot superheroes, which are also like vampires or pirates or both. Instant hit.
Oof.
Love it.
Oof.
Dewan.
I'm gonna go with the explosions.
I'm gonna go with Russian novelists because I was a pretentious teenager. Here we come, Liam.
I'm gonna go with superheroes.
I too am gonna go superheroes. So wealthy!
Oh, nice. Russian novelists are fun.
Yeah, apparently.
Okay.
Obviously.
Great.
Well, that was the plot of Get Him to the Greek, I think.
Was it?
Yes, but with Russian novelists.
Excellent. Well, hey, the world will end tomorrow. What will you do today? I'll finish my novel. Whoever comes after the end should know my legacy. Nobody ends the world but me. I'll end the world today. I always party as if there were no tomorrow, so who cares? They always tell you the world's ending. I'll profit on other people's hysteria. Ooh. I would panic because that's what a real organic person and that's what a real organic person do. And I'm a real organic person. I like that one better. 100 push-ups? No. No, 200 push-ups.
Hey.
I will take people's money. Please.
Bitch better have my money.
Give me the panic, please.
Daniel.
I'm gonna go different today. I'm gonna pick a different route, and I'm gonna go with push-ups. Oh, hey,
surprising.
You see the joke, viewers.
What's the title of your autobiography? My parents think I'm cute, so should you.
I like that.
Wait, what is it?
That's
temporality, the ongoing journey to define my inner enigma. Top 10 drunk texts I don't regret sending. What? Barely have the patience to read a book, dude, let alone write one. The art of punching life in its dumb fucking face. When Garfield met Naruto, a story of how I fell in love with forbidden ships.
Laura, I'm glad.
Oh, God damn it.
I love it.
Dying, Squirtle.
My parents think I'm cute, so should you.
To be fair, saying,
Laura, do I have to ask?
Garfield would make an amazing chunin. Go for it. Garfield Explorer 2's dead.
Daniel.
The art of punching life in its dumb fucking face.
Nice.
I've gotten a different character for every single one.
Oh,
I'm going
Christ.
Sporadic this time.
I didn't mean to pick that, but I needed to.
It had to happen.
Laura, sometimes it's okay.
You gotta, well, that was the most.
That's what Monster Prom's about, man. You gotta go with what's in your heart.
Yep.
Like, I knew realistically, push-ups was not the
Dewan Bibku.
Optimal idea. Oh, Dewan Bibku should go to the sports place.
I'm gonna go to the dime.
Okay.
I never thought a match takes place. Everything seems lost in inspirational speech, spectacular comeback, natural born leader, two charm.
Oh my god, the
sorry,
one.
Plus two charm!
That kidney bean was coming right through your face. You
but I anime faced it out of the way.
But you eavesdrop, Colin.
After your eavesdropping on Miranda and Polly, waiting for the perfect moment to mention your influx of Insta followers when. Well, this already.
Who wants to be space boyfriend?
Never fear, my ladies. You need not fight over me.
All right, who's gonna be who?
Oh, I'll be Polly.
Hell yeah.
Oh, him again.
As royalty myself, I must say that even I find him to be, what's the term you used, Polina?
Extra AF.
Friendship between two beautiful maidens shouldn't be soured over one as handsome, rich, and humble as I. But worry not, my sweet summer salads. I have found the perfect solution to protect your feeble hearts. You shall both marry me.
I've dealt with male entitlement before, but this is official next level.
Yes, an interdimensional level, as our collective wedding will be as well.
Yeah, not interested.
You are hardly the first prince to seek my royal hand in courtship, and I don't see that you're bringing much to the table.
Interdimensional table, and I'm the definition of marriage material. You'll never find a better suitor. I have a castle. I can defeat anyone at anything. I'll show you. I'll fight them. Is the interdimensional prince pointing directly at you? Why is your life like this? I can defeat you at any challenge. Name your weapon and prepare to lose. Ren and Polly are watching you closely. Maybe you can skew the prince. You can skew the prince's challenge to really impress one of them. You know what'd be wild? Naked fencing with live weasels instead of swords.
Yeah.
Or as a royal, you must fancy yourself pretty clever. So let's see you win at losing. That one. Damn it!
Yeah.
Alright.
Yay! Yeah. Colin loses!
It's what true. Else is new? Royalty is very clever. I know, because I'm royalty.
Very well then, let us proceed with the challenges. Series of trials begins. You each post your selfies to Instagram. The prince instantly gains 12 followers while you lose 10.
Round one goes to the home team, it would appear. Sorry about your unfortunate face.
Next up are the classic feats of athleticism. The prince kicks your ass up and down at archery, fencing, and bumper cars.
Yeah.
Finally, you engage in a stirring round of Monopoly. No, I don't. The prince wins within 6 moves. Aha! Normally Monopoly might last days, but I, with my incredible skills, have managed to win it once. Because I am a winner. Now surely I've proven myself worthy of winning groom for both my blushing brides.
Yes, I believe you truly have.
Yeah, I know that technically the point was for you to lose, but losing is a pretty big turnoff.
I like your Amy Gray.
Winning is really much more appealing. I'll go ask my father his policies on polyamory.
You can trust Miranda's father to put the kibosh on allowing his daughter to marry the same prince as a coked out ghost. But you still look pretty dumb. You lose 2 charm and 1 smarts.
Shit. Yay, Nicholas!
Of course.
Kit Anthony.
I love Kit Anthony so much. I'd be Kit Anthony every day if I could. Let's see. I'm gonna go. This doesn't work very well. I'm gonna go auditorium. That day, while rehearsing for the class play, it's as though the blah, 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 blah. You guys know the words here. It will be remembered for generations. That's pretty good for high school. I get creativity. Fantastic. You're trying to focus on your own love life, but the sloppy makeout sounds coming from Violet and Tate are making it difficult.
Who the fuck is Tate?
Hey, that's somewhere else. Oh. The snakes will never be able to digest their food if they have to watch this disgusting display.
Oh no, we don't have Kyle to provide this voice. Let's say somebody take it.
Okay. And my fanfiction muse is running for the hills. How am I supposed to write romance when the two of you are making it look so unappealing?
Well, well, well! Sounds like somebody is a little bit jealous of our amazing, perfect, wonderful relationship. We're not bothering anyone.
You commented on my fanfiction. Still not as romantic as every day with my bae. And then a bunch of heart eye emojis and stars, and also the Komodo emoji? Why did you comment the Komodo emoji?
Caesar, well, it's better to be a strong, independent nightmare creature. Terrifying women, terrifying women.
You don't know what you're talking about. Nicholas, you always trying to romance your classmates in various unlikely ways. It's a couple versus a pair of people who don't understand the joys of being in a couple. Don't want to be the tiebreaker.
Well, if Zoe and Vera don't want to be in relationships, it's going to be hard to get them in a relationship with you. Time to convince one of them. Vera, historically, the only reason why people married was tactical alliances and increasing the wealth of both families. So really, marriages are a great way of solidifying and increasing power and material gain. Or, Zoe, when you're in a relationship, you can do silly couples costumes for Halloween like peanut butter and jelly or puberty and shame. Obviously.
Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, yes! This is exactly what I became in high school.
Was that words?
Did you just throw up?
Don't forget the people who listen and don't watch.
Don't forget to breathe.
To do couples Halloween costumes? That's oddly specific.
Yeah. Yes. Dressing with your love is salt and pepper, a key and a lock, raisins and an air conditioner, windows and doors, a bulletin board and water fountain.
Okay, now you're just listing whatever you say.
Oh, couple's costume idea. You go as Violet and Tate, or Miranda and Damien, Liam x Damien, Calculester x Scott, or Calculester x Miranda.
Now you're just listing our classmates.
Shut up. Of course, if you can't cosplay as your old classmates, how the hell are you gonna cosplay anybody else? Can't get an amen.
Amen!
There's another RuPaul reference.
Bless you. Of course Zoe is a RuPaul's Drag Race fan. Point is, you made her super happy. Maybe one day she'll cosplay the couple of Zoe X Necklace. Plus two creativity, plus one charm to you.
Snugglewomp!
Alright, Snugglewomps.
Anytime.
Let's do this.
Blah,
blah, blah.
Listen to your elders.
Look how smart you are.
You spot Liam showing Calculusser some images on his phone. Two of your classmates interacting without your interference? Unacceptable. You saunter over.
Dan, you want to trade?
Ooh.
So you don't have to do the nasally voice. You can give him whatever you want.
Yes, I will trade with you.
All right. Go for it.
I call this one Mournful Macaroni and Polyethane Cafeteria Tray.
It's pretty good.
If I had to describe it, I would say that it is haunting, challenging, and very artistic.
Adjectives acknowledged. Appreciating art.
Well, if you appreciate that one, you'll really appreciate this next one. I call it Pickled Beets, and it is obviously even more artistic than the last piece I showed you.
Query. How much more artistic is image2.jpg relative to image1.jpg?
Well, a lot more.
Invalid quality, or quantity, please provide a numerical value.
Well, that's a ridiculous question. Everyone knows that art can't be objectively measured.
Counterclaim. All things can be objectively measured. Temperature, altitude, smarts, boldness, charm.
It seems like Calculister is going to list every single thing he can think of and or look up, and that's a pretty goddamn long list. Looks like you need to resolve this, but whose side are you on? There are certainly some things that can't be measured. Calculister, like the admiration I feel for Liam.
No.
Wow, Liam. It's like you haven't read the obscure yet definitive classic, All Art Can Be Objectively Measured, and this book will show you exactly how, by Kandinsky's extremely literal twin brother.
What? No! Of course I've read that book! I was the first one who read it! I read it 100 times! 100! Which is an objective number, just like art is objective! Hey! I gotta go real quick, not to the library, to go read that book or anything. Just...
Hit a button.
Is Liam cold?
Just Sorry. Space! I have to go to space for a concert, or an asteroid that you're not hip enough to know about.
No, he's just Greek.
I think they bought it.
Wow.
You're doing like Seth Rogen doing the count.
You truly Great. Know a lot about measuring things. Allow me to show you my admiration by measuring you.
Aww.
Knowledge of measuring things, 9.6. Hair, 0000000. Oh wait, that's a hex code. Hair, stack overflow, subject is too hot, processor's overheating.
I love him.
You rush Calculester into the cafeteria's meat locker to cool him down, which gives you an opportunity to spend some quality time together. You gain plus two charm and plus one fun.
Charlemagne! We gonna get smort, Charlemagne.
Too bad. That's not smort.
I know, I pushed the wrong button.
That's money.
How do I go back?
You don't!
Good, let's buy something. I gain a bazillion monies! Woo!
You get two of it. You notice Scott and Damien.
You notice Scott and Damien waving their phones in each other's faces and decide to take a look. As you get closer, you realize they're discussing Pokemon's Go, the mobile game based on the hit television show Pocket Humans.
Laura?
Oh, yeah, can I?
All right. Have to.
You bet your ass I do. And check it out, his fiscal responsibility standard 11. He's a fucking beast at doing the taxes.
I heard he's lactose intolerant, though!
Haha, yeah, I feel him. I feel him nothing but cheese pizza to fuck with him. He hates it.
That's not very nice! I'm super nice to my Leslie Dunbar!
Now fuck you! You got Leslie Dunbar, the queen of insurance liability management?
Yeah! I had to trade two Mindy Babcock for Jared Fogle to get her!
Oh no!
But it was so worth it! That's nothing! You got a Pokemon so rare, it'll send them both into shock! You whip out your phone and show them your... Winslow Jibs, fiscal responsibility, 14, armor class 20, loving owner of a speedboat and several dogs, or Scabs Rent-A-Car, sex murderer. Yes, Scabs. Whoa! Oh, I don't care that I lost out. Whoa! I've never seen that one before!
Don't be fooled by the cool character portrait, Scott. Look at the stats. Impulse control 3, work ethic 1.8.
It me!
Fiscal responsibility negative 5.
It definitely me!
And Pokemon might be rare, but he is garbage. Pokemon can't just go through with life, wreck your shit, and do whatever he feel like. You gotta have self control, you gotta have ambition, and you gotta have a diversified stock portfolio. Get this murder hobo out of my face!
The irony of Damien's statements is apparently lost on him, but the real loss is yours. You lose 2 smorts and 1 chorm.
Shit.
Let's trade places!
Choose a brand!
Say your choice out loud to the rest of the players before clicking. Choose a brand.
Choose a brand.
Tone.
I'm
gonna go with Baby Gap.
Ooh.
Ooh.
All right.
Juicy.
Oh, girl.
Supreme.
Shut up, Alan.
Hype Beast.
Wait, what's that one that goes on the hat?
Supreme.
Oh, that is Supreme.
Circuit City.
Ooh, Circuit City. Okay, great. Player order is decided based on how intriguing it would be if the selected brand decided to produce their own TV show. Start debating now.
I feel like a Supreme TV show would just be really sad.
I think it
would
just most of you do.
It would just be like me and Scott doing push-ups for
it would
an
just
hour.
Be, no, it would just be a bunch of kids dressed like anime characters, dressed like characters from fucking The World Ends With You.
Yeah, wide pan shots of kids walking down sidewalks with baggy ass hoodies.
Yeah, right. Everyone's just dressed like Shino from fucking Naruto.
Alright.
Yo, if we're listening to Death Grips the whole time, I'm definitely voting mine.
Alright, where are we going, kids?
Some bones coming
Baby
out my
Gap
mouth.
Is part of the dark web, so let's not go there.
What is?
If it Baby Gap had a TV show, part of the dark web.
Whatever, let's go. Where are we going?
Let's randomize it.
All right.
Why not?
Great.
Be lazy.
We'll never decide.
No. Yeah! Baby Gap! Woo!
Of course I go last.
That's because you suck at this game.
I know!
Juicy Couture, you failed me.
All right. Week 1, are we doing... Oh, let's keep going. Let's keep rolling, baby.
Yeah, let's keep going.
Charlemagne.
35-minute episode.
Who do I want to talk to? Colin, who do you want to talk to?
Are you just gonna?
I'm going to the shop.
Colin?
Oh, you are? No, you're not. You're just trying. Look, my 2 dudes are up there. I'm gonna try to get Lester.
Well, why not sit with him? Well, that's
are
what Antoinette wants.
Are you gonna fuck with my dude?
I might have to. No, you know what? I'm gonna mix it up. I'm gonna go here.
Ooh.
Strange. You could have sworn Polly and Damien were at this table when you picked it.
Hey, looter, down here.
It's us, Polly and Damien, hiding under this table for totally innocent reasons.
You're also Gina, Linetti.
Shut the fuck up.
A ferocious roar sounds from the door of the cafeteria. Crazy Martin, the werebear janitor, is here, and he's looking for someone.
I like him!
Oh, shit, he's here!
Why is he after us anyway? I think what we did really falls more under federal jurisdiction?
International law, more like these munchkins were Canadian citizens.
Now that you mention it, I think we might actually have to face a war crimes tribunal.
That's worth it though, right?
Oh, totally. As long as we can get away from Buzzkill the Bear over there. Ah, rhymes.
Just hide in the ghost zone. You know, the special alternate dimension only ghosts can use? Or hide behind diplomatic immunity. I mean, you're both princes of hell, right? I want to do... I'm down with the ghost zone. I like that.
Yeah, I can't hide in the ghost zone. I'm not a ghost.
I guess you should have thought of that before you spent all that time being alive. Dickhead.
Being alive is not a choice.
Oh, okay. I don't have time to sit here and argue pro-life or pro-choice with you, my dude. See you in the ghost zone.
No, you will not.
You can't follow Polly into the ghost zone, but from the way she winks at you before crossing over, it looks like you're one step closer to the bone zone.
Uh-huh. Nice.
Snuggle wumps. Where you going, girl?
When you arrive at Scott and Calculester's table, Scott is there. He comes back when you sit down, clearly delighted.
Oh man, everybody's butts smell great today. It's like a bouquet of butts, a butt-kay. And look at this, Snugglewumps is here. Hey Snugglewumps, I bet you have a butt for me to sniff.
Scott, I advise you to terminate your current course of action.
What?
Translating previous utterance into Scott readable format. One moment, please. Scott, smelling butts equals bad.
But how can smelly butts be bad when smelly butts is good?
It is not good. It is bad. See also uncouth, invasive, and totally nasty.
But.
Either Scott is malfunctioning, or he's just been distracted by some fun new butts. Either way, you need to find a way to resolve this dispute. You don't understand, Calculester. You use complex analytical software to understand your surroundings. Scott's complex analytical software is smelling butts. Calculester is right, Scott. You've got to be polite and respect people's privacy. Why not present them with an official form requesting a butt smelling? Going with this.
Oh, I already have one of those.
Scott hands you a piece of purple construction paper. On it, he has written, "Can I smell your butt? Why?" and question mark.
Is it the kind of note I would pass in fourth grade?
Also now.
This is not a legally sound document. Allow me to assist.
Calculester prints out 500 copies of a very official-looking bureaucratic form and hands them to Scott. He's clearly put some thought into this.
Form A-55, Anal Olfactory Rendezvous Request. Wow, it's even got a seal from the Bureau of Unilateral Tush Tasting.
Do you see now, friend Scott? Bureaucracy can be fun.
Yeah, I'm gonna go pass these out to everybody.
With Scott gone, Calculester prints out a single copy of a different form and hands it to you. It's form IOU-6969, Romance Escalation Consent Request. Nice! Woo!
Nice!
Nicholas!
Can I will sit.
Nope.
Yes.
You sit down with Zoe and Miranda. Miranda is paying no attention to her eating serfs, and Zoe is paying too much attention to them.
What are you doing, Zoe? Don't you know how rude it is to ogle another woman's eating certs?
I'm not ogling, I'm researching for my fanfic.
My dear, when is it about royalty? When it is about royalty, it is not called fanfic, it is called propaganda.
What? Oh, I'm not writing about you right now. I'm writing about your eating serfs.
What?
Yeah, it's gonna be great. I'm going to really dive into their inner lives, their hopes, their dreams, and desires.
Oh, don't be silly. Serfs don't have any of those things.
Fuck you said.
Do they, serfs?
The eating serf's eyes dart between Miranda and Zoe, terrified. Should they speak or just shut up and eat? You're right, Miranda. Most serfs don't have thoughts or feelings. Only the really expensive rare ones do. Or make menacing eye contact with two serfs, silently place a piece of sushi in your mouth, and chew violently. Should I be threatening? What do you think will impress Zoe?
Probably the top one.
The panel?
I'm gonna assume the top one because
we'll just lie to Miranda.
Yeah, and get her to go away.
That's fair.
Uh-huh. I'm sorry, Miranda. I didn't realize your serfs were common and expensive. I won't ask them any questions.
Wait. Of course my serfs are expensive and rare. They're the most expensive and the most rare.
Damn.
So you're saying they didn't make all of them? They do have rich inner lives?
Rich? Why, their inner lives are positively wealthy, opulent even. Tell them, serfs.
At Miranda's urging, her serfs share with you their childhood dreams of becoming marine biologists, their mutual love of ukulele music, and their well-reasoned opinions on income inequality.
Oh, wow. Thanks, you two. This is really a wealth of information.
Of course it is.
Once again, it looks like lying was the answer. Zoe's certainly grateful. Bing! Dishwan.
Dishwan Bitku.
Guess I'm going to pair. You take your seat besides arguably the two coolest monsters in all Spooky High. Here's hoping you can keep up with them.
Vera, are you eating manticore sticks again?
Yes, and it's delicious.
Don't you know the amount of cruelty involved in the mainstream meat production industry?
Yes, and it's delicious. Besides, Liam, you're a vampire. You only consume things that are dead.
Well, yes, I suppose. But it's always ethnically sourced, organic, free-range, and human. The human population is out of control, and eating them is the most environmentally responsible thing to do.
Listen, Liam, I happen to have a personal feud with every single animal I eat. I make sure to meet all of them first and ensure I'm devouring only the ones I hate the most. Makes it extra tasty.
Well, then, surely you can inflict such pain without going through the cruel meat industry and supporting factory farming. Isn't home cruelty better anyway?
I actually have a point there. If I get my hand in the pot, I can inflict even more effective and specific pain. I bet there's even a way to make money off of this, too.
Hang on. Somehow I've ended up arguing against my own interest here.
Well, you want to find innovative and creative ways to move society forward, or you want to oppose cruelty like every other weak mainstream loser?
You can actually hear Liam's brain shaking as he struggles between his desire to be perceived as ethical and his desire to be perceived as creative. Maybe you can step in and help out. The animals you kill may lose their lives, but what about their afterlives? Instead of letting their spirits go to waste as the byproduct of the meat industry, let's serve their entire soul as a side dish. Stop being distracting, Nicholas! Liam, animals are already suffering, from ignorance. If Vera wanted to increase their pain, the best we can do is to teach them the concept of death so that they really fear their fate. Let's educate cattle on metaphysics. I don't know which one to go with.
Who are you trying to get?
Neither of them, actually.
Oh, well then, whatever you want. They just suck it.
Yeah.
Well, I can't condone animal cruelty, but I wholeheartedly support animal education.
Why does my character sound like the queen of the kitchen?
That's a really good question. You're the one doing it.
Just going to say.
You're the one doing the voice.
That's all your fault.
It was just what I was feeling, okay? I do like animals, but their illiteracy is my fourth least favorite thing about them. Right between the poor taste in fashion and simplistic views on German cinema.
Not the worst idea you've ever had. Although, face it, Dwan Bibko. Bibko, you're only known for having pretty terrible ideas about 50% of the time.
Yeah.
I don't really see building an empire out of private schools for cattle. With my business acumen, I guess it's possible.
And I can rest assured in the knowledge that I'm solving the bovine education crisis.
Helping Liam help cows is like helping you help Liam choose you to go to prom with.
Too many U's.
Or something.
I like it.
Hey, trading places.
Trading places.
What are we?
But shouldn't we trade places next time?
I think we're gonna.
It's pizza time.
Okie dokie.
Yep. Next time on Best Woods, we're gonna be full of pizza. And we're gonna finish this. Finish it. We're gonna do another episode.
And Colin's gonna keep failing.
Yeah.
Why not?
Colin does best.
Because it's good for TV.